You promised my son that you're going to give him free Robux.
Give that poor child his free Robux. Good evening, I'm Bagubuns. Roblox? What is that? I don't know what that is. I've never heard of it. Roblox is only one of the most popular video games in the world. Actually, calling Roblox a game wouldn't be politically correct, but it isn't exactly fully used as a game engine either. It's more like a social experiment. No, that's not right either. It's a free-to-play online experience, made primarily as a game engine and platform for people to share said games for others to play. Though I don't like to admit it, I have spent a lot of time on Roblox myself, and I can feel myself slipping back into its clutches. I consider myself a veteran. I was on Roblox back when tickets were a thing. I feel old. Among the ones that I've been playing for footage, Arsenal's a lot of fun, Doors is really well made, Murder Mystery is thrilling, Build a Boat for Treasure is surprisingly incredible, and there's a platformer that literally goes on forever if you want to be stuck playing one game until the end of time. They're not all crazy well made or anything, but at the very least, they're kind of fun, especially with your friends. There are so many genres here that can scratch any itch from the hardcore shooters to tough-as-nail platformers, story games, action RPGs, and roleplay. Believe it or not, this is one of the top genres. The sheer reach of Roblox is impressive as well, with around 60 to 70 million players every single day. That number is stupid. It shouldn't be real. But it is. Many of the games are either just fine or total garbage. Chat censorship sucks. And who was the guy in charge of making Arthro? I'm gonna come and get you. But yeah, Roblox is a fantastic game made for children and has no issues at all. Alright, enough beating around the bush. As you could probably tell, Roblox has a negative history about how they manage their platform. Roblox has been exposed for exploiting its developers and endangering children. That's a huge issue since Roblox is basically run by minors, yet creates an environment that isn't very safe for them. And if you can't protect children on a platform full of them, that opens up a lot of dangerous doors. However, that was a good while ago. Roblox has committed itself to fixing up its many issues, so let's see where they are now. By the way, you should subscribe to the channel. It's for the children. Can you make money by being a developer for Roblox? Yeah. Are there caveats to that? Also, yeah. Roblox gets a lot of their work from children under 17. Kids develop a good portion of their games. Kids make up 75% of their site traffic. Kids are the ones convincing their parents to buy Robux. And kids are also the ones not making a lot of money off the games they create. This topic was already covered by a channel called People Make Games. Actually, almost everything I'm saying in this video was covered by them. So make sure to watch their two videos on that. However, those videos are from a good while ago. Roblox has seen them, as evidenced by them trying to take it down. Since then, I think they've been trying to tackle the issues head on. I think that's great. So, how much did Roblox change about how they paid their developers? Not enough. In the People Make Games video, they reveal that in order to even get paid at all, a game has to make 100,000 Robux before they could cash out. That's around $1,000. That's a lot of dollars, especially if you're a kid and you have to make that all in game. If they fall short of that threshold, they get nothing. You could have the most popular game in the world, but if you don't make good money off your in-game purchases, you still won't make a single dollar. Now they have lowered the threshold to 30,000 Robux, which is an improvement, but it still means that you have to generate essentially 400 bucks to be able to cash out. If that alone was the policy, then I don't think it would be as big of a deal as I'm making it out to be. But generating 400 bucks doesn't mean you've made 400 bucks, you silly, naive child. Roblox only ends up giving you only about a quarter of that money. It's still basically the exact same system as in the People Make Games video. Even if you manage to hit that threshold, there are users who reportedly still had issues cashing out. Good luck paying for groceries with imaginary currency, am I right, fellas, or am I right, fellas? You know what? Why even cash out at all? It's technically more advantageous to just hold the currency in Robux instead of funneling 3/4 of my earnings into a multi-billion-dollar corporation. It's not even worth anything in the real world. I can't buy a Lamborghini with a billion Robux. You know what I can buy? A low-res JPEG on a virtual t-shirt. Oh wow, that's even better than a new car. Thanks, Roblox. I'm so happy. Roblox is locking you into their man-made economy and not paying you fairly for it. Compare Roblox to other free and accessible game-making software. For example, Unreal Engine, which lets you keep every penny you earn from your game up to $3,000, of which they will subsequently only take a 5% cut. It's like the anti-Roblox. Or Godot, which is good for beginners, and you can negotiate with publishers for royalties and stuff. These engines pay you better, come with more tools, and have better support systems. The only reason you'd use Roblox at all is because of their massive existing player base. Guess what? I have a bone to pick with that as well. So what does it take to have a popular Roblox game that is also profitable? The top 1,000 Roblox developers make around $55,000 a year. And while that is nothing to sneeze at, the chances of you being up in that number is so low because of the billions of other games you are competing against. Also, the top 1,000 Roblox developers are made up of adults and entire studios. What I'm saying is, if you can't get a game to blow up and hit that dollar threshold, you might as well never hit it. The only way to really stand out is to make advertisements, and there is a lot I can say about that. Hey buddy, watch my video about crappy advertisements after this one. It's a lot of fun. To even make people click on whatever you have been cooking up, not only do you have to have decent marketing skills, you also have to have a good amount of money to start with. And do you know what currency these ads run on? Robux! I am such a proud member of the Roblox Society! But wait, it gets even worse, because now even advertising your game is potentially not enough, since Roblox outright decided to get rid of ads on their Discover page and instead move them to places like the Avatar Editor, which is really stupid. If you were on the Discover tab, it's because you were looking for games to play, and it made sense for ads to pop up since that'll usually redirect you to a game. When I'm trying on items and accessories, I'm focused on the thing that will make my little guy look sexy, not ooh, fart simulator. Yummy. Not to mention, the ads are placed in fewer locations and they look smaller to me. So good luck advertising your hard work on the site. Hope you have a popular Roblox YouTuber on speed dial to promote it, because that's probably the safest way to guarantee traffic to your game at this point. And by the way, I know that there is an entire row of games titled Sponsored, and that is likely where a portion of your advertising budget is going, but it's sandwiched between two rows of games you're more likely to play from anyways. Judging by the player counts and ratings on these sponsored games, I don't think you're getting your money's worth. Roblox can only hold so many games in a single row, so there's a chance your game won't even be visible right away. In a world where our attention spans are only getting shorter and our choices become more numerous, nobody's gonna dig through all that junk to find your hidden gem. The fact that even paying for your game to be pushed to more people still makes it a needle in haystack situation is messed up. I don't want to downplay the improvements that Roblox actually has made, since they no longer require you to pay for Roblox Premium to cash out. Oh yeah, I should talk about that. You heard me right. Previously, you had to pay Roblox a monthly fee to make the little bit of money you squeezed out of your game, which is nuts. Honestly, good on them for removing it, but it still doesn't fix much. Payouts are still bad, and advertising still sucks. Roblox is basically forcing a bunch of young developers to put way too much effort into a system that is setting them up for failure. Doesn't matter to Roblox, they're still drumming up a profit. How can a platform that prides itself on how accessible it is to make games actually make the process 10 times more difficult? You can argue that this harsh reality is what real game devs go through. And while I wish it wasn't the case, that's true. However, these are independent creators, many of them being under the age of 17, and they aren't directly employed by Roblox. It isn't enough for you to just make a popular game on Roblox as a little passion project. You have to really crunch for it and use every tool at your disposal to make it as marketable as possible. Hey, can you put me on with the CEO of Roblox? Just make sure he's watching this video, because this message is for him. Hello there, you're screwed. Let me tell you the story of Pokemon Brick Bronze. It was pretty much just the Pokemon game in Roblox. It's really not that deep. It was created by a small team of developers and initially cost 25 Robux before eventually becoming free to play. The thing about Brick Bronze that made it stand out was how well made it was. Probably even better than the mainline Pokemon games released at the time, which were X and Y. Not a very high bar, but still. It was basically open world, had some great animations, a sizable story, PvP support, and pretty much every single Pokemon convention out at the time. I'm telling you, this was ahead of its time. It was really popular, but it also ripped Pokemon assets and ideas straight from the games, and Pokemon didn't like that. So, Pokemon Brick Bronze and a wave of other Pokemon-themed games had to be shut down, or else legal stuff would have happened. I played it a little back in the day myself, not enough to be devastated at my lost progress, but enough to know that a pretty good game was lost to the hands of the Pokemon Company. And I can't blame Pokemon for this at all. I don't think they're the villains in the scenario. I think they're within their right to do so. So, Brick Bronze was later rebranded as a clone with original assets, known as Lumion Legacy. The reason why I'm telling the story is, well, just look at the front page of Roblox. It is filled to the brim with anime stuff, superhero stuff, Sonic the Hedgehog. Okay, yeah, I wonder who the target audience is for these games. But the thing is that these games are popular and making money. This is Blox Fruits, which is based off a popular anime called One Piece. I don't know if you heard of it, it's kind of a small series. It has over 500,000 players right now and has insane ratings, but it directly profits off the ideas, mechanics, and most importantly, names and designs of the source material. For some of these, you could probably argue that you are protected under fair use. Not every game ripped assets from their source material like Pokemon Brick Bronze did, but not every game has to in order for legal action to be present. That's the difference between copyright infringement and trademark infringement. And I'm not saying that the companies will definitely issue takedowns of these games, since I know Sega has no problem with Sonic fan projects, even making a Roblox Sonic game of their own. But Toei Animation, the studio that owns One Piece and Dragon Ball, has a history of striking down people that use their IP. A YouTuber known as Totally Not Mark got over 150 videos struck down by Toei Animation for reviews of anime, which you'd think falls under fair use, but the issue is that Toei Animation is a Japanese company that uses Japanese copyright and trademark rules. If Roblox or the developers of Bloxfruit were sued in Japan, that can cause major issues for any game using trademark stuff. Given that a large portion of Roblox's community are weebs, something like that can be pretty devastating to the community. So, I think that Roblox should start moderating the IPs that people use and encourage their developers to go the way of Lumion Legacy and transition into an original IP that's loosely based on what they already built up. It's not a very popular opinion, I'm aware, but it's probably a safe option that protects the underpaid developers and protects Roblox. There's no real guarantee that a lawsuit or takedown will ever occur again, but the Pokemon Brick Bronze takedown set a very powerful precedent. So, why risk it? I don't want to ruin your fun, but something like this can happen again. Roblox's tools and most of their games are free, yet Roblox is still very valuable as a company. And when they're not making that revenue from child labor, they make a lot of it off of their in-game currency, Robux. Robux can be used to get access to certain games, advertise games, buy game passes within games, and most importantly, make your little guy look really sexy. I might as well add, if your little guy doesn't look sexy and instead has that awful bacon haircut, you will get bullied for it. Sounds kind of racist, but that's also Roblox. You don't have to have Robux to have a good looking character. I have never earned a Robux in my life, and my guy was made completely free of charge. From the hat to the pack to the gold bars to the Choo Choo Rocket t-shirt, which I was able to upload myself. I think it looks pretty cool. But it's kind of ridiculous that Roblox allows people to sell PNGs for 1 billion Robux. In fact, Roblox's entire policy to allow users to price anything they want, however they want, is scummy. And in the end, it benefits the company the most. Roblox only gets money through people buying Roblox Premium or paying for Roblox directly. Since Roblox Premium is pretty much useless, it's safe to say that Robux sales means everything for Roblox. So their entire system benefits the developers whose games incentivize people to spend the most on Roblox. Back in my day, Roblox's games were kind of plain, but they were a lot of fun. Kind of like old people. They perfected their gameplay loop, stripped back the visuals, and while they had content you could pay for, they were little bonuses and donations. You couldn't be tricked into thinking it was a fun game. You just had to play it and experience it for yourself. It's like Flash games or really old games. There was innovation and creativity around every corner, and you could feel the heart and soul of the developers running through the programming of the game. Nowadays, Roblox games are so damn flashy, greedy, and absurd. Kind of like old people. It's truly impressive what now could be done in the Roblox studio. And there are certainly a ton of really good passion projects, but a good portion of the top games in Roblox don't do anything creative or new. They just do the same old things over and over. They're soulless clones of popular games hoping to ride that wave of success. It doesn't matter if there's actual content. As long as it fools people into paying and playing, you win. Since developers already don't make enough money off Roblox, they could just fill the screen with pop-ups and a ring of microtransactions to keep young people's attention spans short and that dopamine flowing. And I could guarantee you, all of these types of games have a gacha or loot box system. Most of the games that are popping off nowadays are pay to win anyways, like those grindy simulator games. There's no end goal. Just click or collect as much as you possibly can and multiply it. You know Cookie Clicker? Now imagine that, but with Robux, which is worth real money, to speed up your progress. What do you gain out of it? A nice little rush of satisfaction to your brain, I guess. It's repetitive, doesn't require much skill, and really easy to market to kids. While that's the most egregious example of this predatory type of monetization, it gets even worse in games where you actually need to be competitive. You could pay to be more powerful. How incredibly fair of you. It's not fun for the people who can't throw around that kind of money. Why play a game at all if you're just gonna lose to some privileged kid with a fat stack of Robux in his virtual pockets? Why even experiment with a cool and unique idea anymore? You can make way more money by making pay-to-win garbage. It's easier to produce. Easier to monetize, and easier to promote to young people. That's the platform that Roblox wants. They benefit from the system way more than their developers do. I get that servers are expensive to maintain and the tools Roblox provides won't develop themselves, but I find this whole thing kind of predatory. Speaking of predators, let's talk about Roblox creeps.
Here, I thought that creepers were only in Minecraft.
First, we have to address the online dating issue in Roblox. Just that phrase, online dating in Roblox, should be setting off all sorts of red flags. Roblox, with all its colorful, child-targeted games, provides a virtual playground for young kids, over half of them being under 13 years old, and over 75% of them being minors. And while the children play on this playground, out from the shadows comes the predators. Online pedos camp out in places full of children because they know they can hide behind their anonymity. Roblox provides everybody with a little guy that you could dress up like a doll. The person on the other end of the screen can actually be another little fella, or they could be a weirdo, like DJ Khaled.
Life, there's Roblox.
Truer words have never been spoken. It's already so troublesome that online dating is so ingrained in Roblox's culture, but keep in mind, the next time you play Adopt Me, there's a high chance that mommy and daddy have a pretty significant age gap. Ew! It's not like Roblox allows you to do dirty talk in the chat box because of their censorship rules. Roblox doesn't even allow your avatar to be naked anymore, but Roblox still can't stop their users from trying. There are full-on lobbies where developers have found a way to game the system. Not only creating games where you roleplay a porno, but also somehow get around Roblox's protection system. In one such case, a gang of players decided to bang a girl's avatar without consent. The victim in question, a 7-year-old girl.
These are not rare occurrences. Look in the news, and this happens way too frequently. And let me say that I think parents should take a bit of accountability here. Don't leave children on a site that has a very public issue with sexually charged online interactions. Or any site at all, really. You should monitor what your young kids do online, but Roblox themselves should make the first move in cleaning up their platform.
You will get banned if you're reported for online dating or doing something of sexual misconduct, but only really if you're reported. Judging by the fact that I'm looking at it right now, that's not happening very often.
Of course, Roblox in the situation is doing what they do best, disguising the problem rather than fixing it. And their solution is wild.
Roblox is trying to add age verification so that more mature players can have more mature experiences, like a Hooters for furries. This is a real thing. Please end me. By the way, mature in this case means being 17 and up. And 17 is still underage in a lot of countries. And no, Roblox, age is not just a number. In fact, the CEO of Roblox himself encourages older Roblox users to basically use Roblox as a dating app.
That's the CEO presenting about how cool Roblox Tinder will be. Swiped right on that idea.
There are still minors in these games. Even so, Roblox can't really force age verification, and there's no guarantee that it can't be outmaneuvered. Once you're verified, you got access to a whole Roblox world full of alcohol, violence, and strippers. It's far from easy, and it's very illegal, but if your kid is willing to steal your credit card for Fortnite currency, they're gonna be willing to go to extreme lengths to commit identity fraud to play furry Hooters. Verification is only required to join the 17 plus exclusive games, and it doesn't prevent the disgusting things going on in the kids' games. But it's still kind of nice seeing Roblox try to tackle this age-long issue on their site, even though they are failing miserably. Notice that I said the words on site and failed miserably. Roblox had a history of not only random users, but developers promoting straight-up sexual abuse on their forums. But after Roblox shut them down, the community spread out all across the internet to social media. Instead of putting an end to the issue, Roblox has instead spread it to every corner of the internet. In one particularly bad case, Roblox directed a young girl to Snapchat and Discord servers full of older men that not only coerced her into giving them explicit pictures, but also robbed her of her Robux. All the while, Roblox turned a blind eye to the problem that they caused. This issue affected her for years. She developed severe mental health issues and even had to be pulled out of school because she wanted to end her life multiple times. She was only around 10 or 11 years old, and she's gonna have to live with this trauma potentially for the rest of her life. And Roblox just acted like it wasn't their problem. Thankfully, Roblox was held accountable with a lawsuit, but honestly, going through this thing makes me even more angry because written in the lawsuit itself were cheap and easy ways for this stuff to be prevented. Things like actually reliable age verification, or being alerted when adults are messaging minors, or limiting the things that minors can do without adults around. It's not only Roblox, it should be every social platform. It is way too easy to fake your identity and your age online, and that shouldn't be okay. I don't think Roblox is doing all this shady stuff out of ill will. At least, I don't think their entire business model was to make the life of their player base super harmful, but I seem to have caught Roblox in an awkward puberty phase, where they want to fix some of their issues, but nothing seems to be working for them. They are trying to be an all-encompassing metaverse and are branching out without any clear direction. I see a lot of potential for improvement, and there have been a lot of positive changes made, but it feels like substantial change only comes when somebody twists Roblox's arm. That's an issue if you have over 70 million people that are going to be affected by your actions every single day. Roblox has so much creative potential, and I never had any doubt that they could draw that creativity out of their users with their tools. Maybe a bit too much creativity sometimes, but the way Roblox is currently being run forces their developers to play it safe, forces people to interact with each other for monetary or sexual gain. And that's not an environment befitting of a platform full of young kids and teens. Roblox's decisions are making it less enjoyable nowadays, and it's not just the sentiment I myself express. It used to be a place with unique projects and fun, rewarding events. Although I will say that Lil Nas X's Roblox concert was an interesting choice. But now everything feels so stiff and corporate. As much as there still is to like about Roblox, there's just as much under the surface that is potentially really harmful. Even right now, there is so much cleaning up left to do. But if any company were to have the resources to clean up their environment, then it should be Roblox. Next time I return to this platform, I hope it's a lot nicer, but maybe I'll find myself logging onto a wasteland. Your move, Roblox. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody. Yeah.